Earlier this week, noted anti-Medicare for All Democrat Amy Klobuchar came out and attacked both the Senators Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders over their support of Medicare for All, claiming that this is unrealistic, they're never going to be able to pay for it. Buttigieg came out not that long ago, did the same thing, attacked these two senators running for president because they're supporting a position that is hugely popular. Biden has come out attacking them. Most of the other people running for president on the Democratic side have attacked them. Most, not all. Here's the thing. All of these people who are coming out and attacking Medicare for All, they're doing it using industry-funded talking points. Studies have proven that. And here's the thing. Here's the thing that these people don't understand. One, yes, we do have plans to pay for it. And what's going to happen under those plans is that working-class families here in the United States are going to save thousands of dollars per year. I use myself as an example here because I've done the math on myself. I went through and I figured it out. When you include the insurance premiums I pay out of every single paycheck, along with my co-pays and deductibles for prescriptions that have to be filled every single month, I am paying right at about 25% of my income on healthcare. A quarter of the money that I earn goes to insurance companies. It goes to hospitals, it goes to doctors, and it goes to big pharma. 25% of my income. I'm an average person here in the United States, and I say that quite literally. I am middle income, I am college educated, I'm white, I'm married, I got kids, I got two dogs, own a home, I got student loans, I got mortgage payment, I got car payment. Very, like, statistically, like, quite possibly the most average type human being you could find. And that's why I do use myself as an example, because this applies to most of us. So 25% of my income out the door, insurance, doctors, big pharma. So let's say for a second that Medicare for All is going to cost me 15% in taxes. It's not even that high. I'm throwing that out there because that is a very high number. And it's also very easy to say, okay, cost me 15%. I'm paying 25% right now. So guess what that means? It means I'm saving 10%. That's a couple thousand dollars back in my pocket, back in your pocket. I'm willing to bet I don't have many people in the top 1% watching these videos. So 99% of you watching this are going to save a couple thousand dollars a year if you currently have health insurance, even if you're like me and it's employer-sponsored healthcare coverage. That doesn't even touch the savings that corporations are going to have, which is a huge talking point that I'm really disappointed not enough people are mentioning. Companies, corporations, businesses, you save a ton of money. How are you not supporting this? That's nuts. So here's the thing. We're saving a few thousand bucks. What do we do with that money? We put it back into the economy. What does that do? It creates more jobs. Has more money flowing throughout the economy. You know, the ripple effect goes on and on and on. So not only does Medicare for All save us money, it helps to stimulate the economy. Folks, there's literally no drawback to this plan. Literally none. And I refuse. Maybe things might be different once we get to the general. I refuse to back or support any candidate in this Democratic primary that does not support Medicare for All. And folks, I encourage you to do the same thing. This is the litmus test, all right? This is the line in the sand. You don't support Medicare for All? You want to use industry-funded talking points because they're also putting money in your campaign? Fair enough. But get the hell out of the way, because you'll never get my support.